The world's changed a lot. It's full of technology nowadays, but these crafts are a living connection with our past. There's a lot to clog making. I can see a whole lifetime of learning. It's not something you can learn from a book or from the internet. You really need to see somebody do it. You really need to be taught by somebody who knows how to do it. Clogs are a really important part of our history. It's what everybody wore for hundreds and hundreds of years.
They used to say that you left a bit of bark on, and you can just see there's the bark's on the edge of that. They did a curve for the toe, and they put a nick in where the ball of the foot goes, just to allow it to dry.
People are going, oh, you're the expert, and I'm saying, no, I'm the only one. The hand is becoming increasingly painful to use. I mean, I can do everything, but I'm just wondering, maybe I've got 5 years before this hand becomes unusable. So I need to, you know, to pass these things on. We're on 2.5 carvers at the moment. We've got the half there working at the moment, which would probably be a full.
Working with somebody who knows the craft inside out and has been doing it for most of his life is amazing. There's something really therapeutic about creating something from scratch. You start with a piece of wood and you turn it into something tangible that you can hold and see and can be useful to somebody. There's a lot of traditional crafts that used to be mainstream. There's now only one or two people left doing it for each craft.
Basically, you're training somebody and you're casting them off in a leaky boat, saying, off you go. There's seed banks around the world to keep all these different things alive because maybe they'll be needed to be used in the future. And you could say the same thing about crafts because you don't know what's coming up. Is it of any worth? Well, once it's gone, it's gone.